Good morning, students. Today we'll continue with our next part of the 15th problem, 14th problem. Okay, so up till now in morning also you had covered one lecture, that was up till the 14th problems. Now with time passes, this will be your last lecture officially. Henceforth, what we are going to be doing is we will be sending you problems solution in steps. Okay, in our problem practice lecture. Okay, this officially this would be last lecture, and henceforth you are required to solve the problem on your own. Okay, henceforth in each and every problem practice session, that is at the end 4:15 to 5 o'clock, at that time we will send you the remaining questions. Okay, everyday sum. Okay, if you are able to solve, you can solve it on your own as well. Okay, all the most of the problems will have almost covered in this lecture. Okay, so see for the 14th question, everyone. Okay, make your PDF ready or write the question first. So let's write. A body is projected with velocity 3/4 of escape velocity. A body is there and it is projected. It's projected with what velocity? 3/4 of the escape velocity. Escape velocity from the surface of the earth. Okay, the height it reaches is, what is the height that the body will reach? Okay, students. Now, students, whenever a body is thrown with escape velocity, it will go into space and it will never come back. But if you throw with little lesser velocity, then what will happen? It will go into space and never come back. If little lesser, then it will reach certain height and perform ellipse or parabolic path. And if exactly equal to orbital velocity, then it will keep on in circles. If it is still lesser, then it will ride certain height and fall down. Yes, this is that what we have understood. Yes, but now in question they have given that the velocity with which it is thrown is equal to the escape velocity. Is equal to which velocity? The escape velocity. Okay, so if you are throwing with escape velocity, 3/4 of the escape velocity, it is to be thrown. To be thrown with how much velocity? 3/4 of the escape velocity. You know what is the escape velocity. Always remember, whenever I ask you escape velocity of on the surface of the earth, you will promptly say it is 11.2 kilometers per second. Means how much? That this body has to be thrown with 11.2 kilometers per second, it would escape. Okay, now you are going to throw with 3/4 of that speed, then it will not escape because it is lesser than at the actual escape velocity. So it will reach certain height. So what height it will reach, that we have to find it out. Good. Now for this solution, how can we use comparison method, because only one object is there, right? So we are not going to compare with anything else. So what we have done is, in comparison method we have to find the value of other body, right? But here the same body which is thrown, its height we have to find it out. So what we have to do, we have to use one more technique. That technique is also a new technique, and that is very useful technique. And this technique is almost most predominantly used up till 12th standard also. This is the most beautiful and most interesting and most useful technique. Okay, and a technique that is also reliable and can be used anytime, that is called as principle of conservation of energy, which says that energy remains conserved. Means what? Energy remains conserved means whatever energy you give in the form of velocity, when you throw it with velocity, you have given it certain energy, right? So with the same energy it will go, and this energy will remain conserved. Means what? This energy will not get lost, it will convert itself into some another form. Okay, that principle we are going to use. So what, students, will happen? You are going to throw it with kinetic energy. As you throw it up with kinetic energy, what happens? It comes back, yes, but as it goes up, at the point when it is has zero velocity, means at complete still point, at that point when I'm lifting this up, okay, I'm doing work, right? I'm doing work. Where has this work gone? See, if I leave it, falls down, right? I have lifted this up, means I'm doing certain work. Where has this work gone now? If I leave it, what happens? I'm lifting it. If I leave it, what happens? It falls down. Means what? When I'm doing certain work, energy gets converted. Okay, when I throw it up, what happens? Kinetic energy. Yes, when I throw it, I give it kinetic energy. But as it rises upwards, what happens? The kinetic energy gets converted into new form of energy that we call it as ability to fall down, ability to do work. That is potential energy. It gets potential, it has got strength to fall down, it has got strength to move, right? That means it has got into potential energy. So whenever a body is through at the bottom sometime, so it has got with velocity, by the virtue of velocity, it has got half mv square, that is kinetic energy. But as it moves higher, at this point it is not moving, so it has new form of potential energy. What is that? What is that? It has now, it has got ability to fall down, right? Ability to do work. That means it has got some potential that we call it as potential. See, it has got some potential that we learn in next lesson in deep. Okay, it has got potential energy. So now we have, according to law, this energy, what we spend, okay, or let us say if I throw a ball over upside. So what happens? Whenever you throw, you give energy, right? You give velocity to it. So that energy, as it rises up at the top position, that energy remains in that body in the form of a new energy. That is called as a potential energy. And both value have to be equal. So you have this equation set up for you. When this is equal, you have an equation. And an equation, if one thing is unknown, you can find the other thing. Yes, students? So write this down perfectly on one page. So nicely said, you box this entire thing. See, again what we have written. The formula for the kinetic energy gets converted into potential energy. You will learn in next lesson that the formula for kinetic energy is half mv squared. And the formula for potential energy is mgh that we have used here directly. But in next lesson, you will come to know how this formula has come. And many of you must have been knowing this formula. Kinetic energy equals half mv squared. Potential energy equals mgh. Okay. Both of these are equal. So let's continue this problem solving. Okay. Okay, now here the problem was, the body was thrown with 3/4 of escape velocity. Yes, now we have this equation set up, half mv square equals mgh. Now what is half mv square? Half mv square is the kinetic energy and mgh is the potential energy. Now half m, now what is the velocity at which you are throwing the ball? You are throwing the ball with which velocity? V, that is equals to 3/4 of escape velocity. Yes, students, and yesterday we and today morning also we saw, okay, that what is that? What is the value of escape velocity? It is nothing but, what is this value of escape velocity? It is under root 2gr. Yes, students, what is this value? This value is equals to this value. Escape velocity value is under root 2gr. Always remember, ve equals to under root 2gr. So this value. And if we are on the surface of the earth, then small r equals to what? Capital R. So we have to put V equals to 3 by 4 into under root 2 G R. Getting? Okay. Now, instead of V, if V is the velocity with which you are throwing, so this is nothing but 3/4 of escape velocity. So what is the value of velocity now? That which you will throw? That is nothing but V square. And that velocity will be nothing but this velocity. Because it is 3/4 of the escape velocity. This velocity is 3/4 of the escape velocity. Its value becomes this much. So we have to do the square of the velocity with which it is thrown. It is to be thrown. And what is it is to be thrown with value? 3/4 of escape velocity. So V equals 3/4 of under root 2gr. Therefore V square equals what? 3 squared is 9. 4 squared is 16. Under root square becomes? Under root square. They both cancel each other. So we can write it as V squared equals how much? 9 by 16 2gr. Okay, this is g. So 2 8s are. Is it okay? Yes. So V square becomes how much? 9 by 8 gr. So we will substitute it here. Okay, equals to mg into h. Now here, because the body is thrown from the earth. Okay. From the surface of the earth as equilibrium, and potential energy is considered. The potential energy is considered. The potential energy is considered considering that earth is at the equilibrium. Means from the earth only we are going to take. That is why we are, instead of small r, we have put the word capital R. Okay. So we can substitute here. Half m, you have to write this. V squared is what? 9 by 8 g r equals what? m G H. Okay, M get cancelled with M, G gets cancelled with G. Okay, so what do we have here? The height, to which it should reach is G R. Sorry, G has 9. This is 9. This is not G. G have we have cancelled. So 9 upon 16. 9 upon 16 times the radius. This is the actual height with which the body must have gone according to the principle of conservation energy, which is considered from Earth's surface as equilibrium and the potential energy. Okay, and the potential energy. Okay, yes, so height to which it is must have considered means what? Whatever energy you give, that gets converted into potential energy. Potential energy's formula we have equated by considering Earth as Earth's surface as equilibrium. Okay, Earth's surface as equilibrium. So this height is also considered from the Earth's surface only. This height is also considered from Earth's surface only. Okay, students. Whatever height it will rise, h, that is equals to how much? 9 by 16 times r. Okay, this is capital R. This is more than the radius. Okay, if you have been throwing the ball with certain velocity, it still has got kinetic energy, and that rises up, gets converted into potential energy. Yes, students. Simplified, law of conservation of energy. Energy can never get lost, whatever happens. Energy should never get lost, whatever happens. Energy is conserved. Good. Let's go for the next problem. Next question is, the gravitational force with which Earth attracts Moon. The gravitational force with which Earth attracts Moon is less than the force with which Moon attracts the Earth. Next, equal to the force with which Moon attracts the Earth. Greater than the force with which Moon attracts the Earth, that varies with phases of Moon. This question is very simple. Earth and Moon, they attract to each other. Earth and Moon. Earth. If Earth pulls the Moon with certain force, then what we call it? Force of gravity on Moon. That is what? G m small m upon, let us call this distance between these centers as r, between center to center, r square. And what is this? Moon is accelerating towards Earth. Okay, Moon is accelerating towards Earth. Means what? Mass of the Moon is accelerating by this value. Okay, so that is ma. So f of g. See, the mass of Moon is so less. Mass of the Moon is so less. That is why Moon accelerates towards Earth more. Okay, because force of gravity, that which it attracts here. Okay, now listen, remember. Now listen one more thing. The force with which Moon attracts the Earth has to be equal and opposite. Because when Moon, Earth is pulling Moon towards itself, to balance, okay, to balance the zero equilibrium state, the Moon also has to react with same force on the opposite side, because there is, to every action there should be equal and opposite reaction. Okay, because if I am trying to pull you, okay, if I am trying to pull you, that means at the same time what happens? You are getting some force, you are experiencing some force on your side as well, and that is equal. Okay, without my force, you cannot experience your own force. Yes? Yes, students? Or there cannot be any, if I try to pull you, it cannot be that you will not experience my force. You have to experience an equal and opposite force. Okay, this happens at the time of application only to each and every force. So at the time of application of Moon, there has to be equal and opposite force. Okay? Because as you pull something, there should be certain balance condition that is reserved. Balance condition is always reserved. So at the same time, we have force of gravity on Moon also. Force of gravity on Moon, that is equal and opposite from Newton's third law. Equal and opposite. What is that? G m m upon r square. Now here, who is being pulled? The bigger mass is being pulled. So what is the acceleration? It is capital M into A2. Let us write AM. It is A2 only. Now your mass of the Earth is so big. Okay, so it is accelerating with very, very small value. So accelerations are different. Earth moves towards moon with very small acceleration because its mass is more. But moon, its mass is less. So it moves with larger acceleration towards Earth. Okay, they both pull towards each other. They both pull each other with equal force. But why do they not fall upon each other? Because as moon rotates, as anything rotates, it experiences centrifuge outwards. Okay, so Earth, moon rotates around Earth, but because of the centrifuge force that is going to push them outside, the outward force and the gravitational force both remains cancelled and they keep on balanced state. Okay, so here we have that both attract to each other with equal and opposite force. Okay, students. Okay, here what we have used, here we have used Newton's third law. 15th question. Okay, write Newton's third law and understand this. Okay, the answer to this is by Newton's third law, equal and opposite force. So moon also experiences equal force with which moon attracts the Earth. Simple. Good. Next, the value of G at a place increases with at one place the value of increases. By value of G increases. How does the value of increase at one place? G at a place increases with which value the value of G should increase? The value of G never increases, but the value of increases as you go to the poles. Okay, so poles means what? Increase in latitude. Okay, latitude is different. Latitude means the angles. Zero, equator, 23.5, Tropic of Capricorn, Cancer, and all these are latitudes. Okay, you have must have seen this. So latitudes, we have understood latitudes in lecture. This is 0 degree latitude. Earth is a little tiltedly we have taken. This is 23.5. These are all lines are called as latitudes. And as latitudes increase, 0 degree, 90 degrees, you reach towards the pole. And at the pole, the value of G is maximum. Okay, so it increases with latitudes. Good. Next. Okay. The distances between the two planets from the sun are 10 to the power 13 and 10 to the power 12. The ratio of their time periods is, now this is very interesting. This is on Kepler's third law. This is on Kepler's third law. Okay. So we will see. There are different planets. Write this question in your notebook, please. This question separately you write it and solve it. Distances of two planets, Neptune and Saturn, from the sun are 10 to the power 13 and 10 to the power 12. Meters respectively, the ratio of time periods of the planets are. Okay, this is sun. Okay, sun. Here somewhere Earth lies, all the planets. And then here you have Saturn. And the last planet is Neptune, right? So first we have to draw Saturn. And then we have Neptune here. And see what they have told is, Saturn has its own elliptical orbit. Neptune also has its own elliptical orbit. Okay, now what they have given is more far it moves, more time it should take. Yes, because as you move away, what Kepler has said, as the semi-major axis increases, semi-major axis of the ellipse, as the radius increases, time period also increases. But does it increase in straight line graph? Does it increase with this? If this increases two times, time period also increases two times. Is it the linear graph or straight line graph? If this increases two times, this also increases two times. Is it increasing like this? No. How is it increasing? It is increasing with the ratio. Yes, it is directly proportional. That means T is directly proportional to R. But how is it increasing? T squared is directly proportional to cube. The value of cube of R is proportional to the value of square of R. Okay, this is not normal directly proportional. This is a little different. You will learn this when you come to know in maths also, or with graphs. But now for now, what did you understand? That as the radius increases, time period also increases. Means what? It will take more time to complete one year. It's year. It will take more number of time to complete its period of revolution. That is, time will be more. Okay, so now what is given? Saturn and Neptune, two planets are given. So what we have for Saturn, we have Saturn's time period squared will be directly proportional to Saturn's radius cube. Yes or no? Yes. Similarly, we have Neptune's time period squared is directly proportional to Neptune's radius cube. Is it not two situations? Now two situations are there in which most of the values are given to you. Okay, and you have to find the unknown value. It is this type of question. So what we can do here? See here, there is some proportionality constant also if you solve. Okay, if you solve, then what is the proportionality constant? This, if you solve further, then what is it? T upon S square. If we want, there will be some proportionality constant, right? There will be some proportionality constant. Proportionality constant means if what times of that it is going to happen. Means, for example, when a certain, let us take a boy. If a boy eats two chapatis, then he runs 20 meters. Okay, then what is its constant? If he runs one, if he eats one chapati, then he is going to run 10 meters. Like this, this was one constant. But about another girl, if we take, then if she eats two chapatis, she runs 40 meters. That means her constant is 20. But next time, if the boy will eat three chapatis, he will run only 30 meters. If the girl eats three chapatis, she will run 60 meters. So both have got difference in what? Constants. Right? So what is constant? Constant is just a multiplying factor. So here we have one constant. Let us call it K. Okay. That is, in comparison method, it gets cancelled, students, because we are talking about same constants. Kepler's law is same for all the planets. Yes, because it is universal Kepler's law. Okay, so TS is directly proportional to R cube. Similarly, TN square is equals to K into RN cube. Now, what do we have this? This is a setup as equation. Now, we can write this equation 1 and equation 2 and take their ratios. And take their ratios. Why do we take the ratios? Because we get simplified terms. Yes. So, TS squared upon TN squared is equals to K RS squared upon K RN cube. Sorry. We have a cube here. Now, what happens when we take ratios? Same terms get cancelled. Now, what is given to us? See, the distances between the Sun and Neptune and Saturn are given. Means what? Neptune and Saturn are given 10 raised to the power 13. This distance is given. What is this distance? 10 to the power 13 meters. And this distance is also given. What is this distance? 10 to the power 12 meters. Is it? Yes. So, just now we put the values. Saturn is given by 10 to the power 12. Neptune is given by 10 to the power 13. It's cube, whole cube I have written. Okay. Now what they are asking? Ratio of time periods. Ratio of time periods of TS upon TN. So they are asking T Neptune is to Saturn ratio is what? For the same question, they are asking the ratio of time periods of the planets in the sequence. In the question sequence, they have put TN upon TS. So we'll inverse this by invert into. By inverted, what do we have? Tn. Oh, we have to square here. Huh? Don't miss that part. Ten raised to 13 upon 10 to the power 12 whole the cube. Now what happens, students? See, if you have to further solve this, what happens? Tn upon Ts whole squared gives you 10. Now if you solve this, we have this formula, a raised to m upon a raised to n. This gives you in maths one new function called a raised to m minus n. Simple. So we have 10 raised to 13 minus 12 raised to cube. So now we have tn upon ts equals 13 minus 12 is 1, 10 cube is 10 into 10 into 10, 1000. And this is square here. On the opposite side, it should become square the root. So we have, if you want to ratio, divide it by 1. So what is this? 100 into 10 upon 1. So 100 root is 10. 10 root we cannot find out. So 10 root 10 upon 1 should be the answer of T n upon Ts. T n upon Ts should be. Option number D. Good. Now let's go on for the next question. Understood, students? Very simple. This, in this type of question, just take the ratios. Just take the ratio. So what is the ratio that the planet Neptune will take? How much times more? It will take 10 root 10 times more. 10 root 10 times more. What is 10 root 10 value? Root 9 value is 3. root 9 value is 3. So root 10 value should be little more than 3. So if I multiply little more than 3 here, so 10 into 3 is 30. So it will take 30 times more time if Neptune is considered, Neptune is covering its orbit in, let us take 1 unit of time, then Saturn is revolving in 1 unit of time. If Saturn is revolving around the Sun in 1 unit of time, then Neptune will revolve in how many units of time? 30 times more than that of Saturn. Simplified? Good. What happens? It is 30 times more. And see about the distance. Distance is how much? Only 10 times more. Okay, 10 raised to 12 upon 10 raised to 13 is how much? 10 times. When the distance is varying 10 times, time period is varying 30 times. Are you getting why this square is to cube, how this square is to cubes ratio has resulted into which answer? It has resulted into the radius getting 10 times, time period is getting 30 times. So this different function is given by new third law, that is t square is directly proportional to r cube. Student, this was observed by Kepler. Okay, so here's it. Next question. Yes, next question. The escape velocity of Earth is 11 kilometers per second. The escape velocity of planet having twice the mass and twice the radius will be. This you are going to solve. Somebody is going to solve it now and send it on the group now only. Two bodies of mass 2 kg and 8 kg are separated by distance 9 meters. Then the point where resultant gravitational field is 0 is at a distance of. Question number 19th. You have to write it out. This is a question on null point. Very important question. Write it down in your notebook. Question number 19, please write it on your notebook. Two bodies of mass 2 kg and 8 kg are separated by distance 9 meters. Then the point where the resultant gravitational field is 0 is at a distance of. Did you understand the question? Read the question 2 or 3 times. There are two bodies, 1 and 2. Are they equal? No. Then what are they? One is 2 kgs, 2 kgs, and another is 8 kgs. 8 kgs has to be little more bigger, not 8 times in volume. Yes, 4 times in volume. Okay, now students, what will happen? Both of them will have certain gravitational force between them. Yes or no? Yes. Why? Because they both are any two particles in the universe. And what gravitational law says? Any two particles in the universe pull each other with some force called as gravitational force. So these both have to pull each other. Now what happens? We have to find a null point. What is null point? Null point is a point where which both the bodies, okay, experience equal force or impose equal force. See, if there is a gap in between, if it is on, let us call this Earth, let us imagine this is Earth and let us imagine this is Moon. If you throw an object on Moon, Earth, it will fall down. If you throw an object on Moon, also it will fall on Moon. But what happens if I throw it high? It will fall on Earth. If I throw it high, it will still work. But when if I throw it high such that it reaches Moon's field, it will fall on Moon. But if you just throw it enough to, there will be some point where both of them will be pulling each other, that body, that one point. If I take this marker, this is Earth and this is Moon, this body will be pulled at both the sides. So what will happen at that point? It will neither go here, neither go there. Yeah, the both of them will have their own field. Both of them will have their own field. It will have its own field, like its own radar. In its radar, if you find him, then you will capture him. He will pull you back in his field. Okay, this is called as field, gravitational field. You call. Okay, you have this in your next standards, higher standards in 11th standard. We will not go deep. If I tell you anything in deep, then you will start asking me more doubts. So I am not telling you too much. Okay, so what happens here? We have to find a point. That point is this point, that is called as null point. Now in that null point, what is that? Moon and Earth both impose equal force on that body. So this body will neither get pulled from both the sides, yes, and it will neither go here, neither go there. It will remain floating in space. At that point, you call it as NULLPOINT, null point. Good. Now, how to find this? Just with the help of maths and equations. Okay. So, what we have to do? We have to set up equation. We have to put our own known values and then ask the equation. How would you equate? That means what? Let us assume that the point already exists. And let us call it at distance x, because we have assumed it. It exists. Now, the total distance between the planet is r, as usual, because we have defined it. What does this become then, students? Just tell me if I'm wrong. Is it r minus x? Very good. So this distance becomes r minus x. Now, this mass is given 2 kg. This mass is given 8 kg. Now, here is, let us, now in order that to find null point, we have to assume one more thing. First thing assume what? Null point at x. Null point is at x. Is at x. What is the next assumption? That point, there is a, on the null point, we have placed a body. Because that body has to experience force. Only then it will experience equal and opposite force. And only then we will equate this force equal to that force. For that to put into an equation, it should experience force. And force is experienced only when there is a certain body. So we will put a body there. And in order to simplify the equations, we will put that body's mass to be at 1 kg. Because it is easy to calculate when it's 1. Right? So we will put that its mass is unit mass. And it is put for testing, na? It's used for only testing, for testing purpose. So also called as test mass. Good. Now what happens to that test mass? Let me highlight that test mass. 1 kg block. Oh, you have that 1 kg in market. 1 kg. Zoom it. Okay. Now students, what the part we are going to set up the equation, put the values and get the answer. Okay. Yes. Okay. So, just wait. Think about it. What can we do now? Think about it just. Null point to find out. Then this body will equal force experience equal and opposite force. It will experience certain force here. And same force it will experience there. So we will write for body 1 kg. For body 1 kg. Force imposed by moon. And force imposed by Earth. R equal at null point. Okay. One little correction I would do. Instead of moon, we have a 2 kg body, and instead of earth, we have a 8 kg body. This question can be imagined more vividly when you place earth and moon, because in 8 kg, 2 kg, you cannot actually really see existing gravitational force. So I better took here moon and earth to help us solve. Okay. Force imposed by moon. Gmm/r². Only we are going to talk about force moon and moon upon that 1 kg. So only this in field. Gmm/r². So that is G 2 into 1 upon, what is this distance? x². Okay. This on this side is equal to force on that side, because we are assume that it is on null point where both forces are equal and opposite. So it is equal to what? Okay, it is, what is this force? Force imposed by earth, that is on by 8 kg on null point. G 8 into 1 upon, what is this distance? R minus x the whole square. Now these two are forces. Actually there is 8 kg body trying to pull this 1 kg, and there is this 2 kg body that is also trying to pull that 1 kg, and we have to find null point. So we have assumed that that is placed on null point, and at null point both forces, that 1 kg will be pulled by both of them equally, so it will not go anywhere, it will stay there. Why? Because both forces are acting equal and opposite, so we'll put equal. Equal and opposite. Opposite means what? Force should be minus here. Okay, so just now we will equate its magnitude. We'll equate its magnitude. G should get cancelled with G. Okay, now we'll write it separately. Okay, 2 upon x squared. 2 upon x squared equals 8 upon r minus x the squared. Take it up on the cross multiply. 2 by 8 equals x squared by r minus x squared. 2 1s are 2 4s are. 1 by 4 equals x upon r minus x the whole square. Square on this side should become root. 1 upon 4. 4 root is 2. Help me to solve. Is it root of 4, 2? So write it here separately. And put it here. Okay. This square on this side. Now cross multiply. This term here, r minus x. This term here equals to 2x. Minus on this side becomes plus. So r is equals to 3x. And what is x? 3 multiplying here, it will divide. So students, you got one thing. That is what? R by 3. R by 3, let me see, it is right or wrong. It is right. Okay. So r by 3 is actually the distance that is equals to, that means this distance between the moon and the earth, or our 2 kg and our 8 kg, it's such that x is equals to 1/3 of the whole distance. That means if it would be kept at 9 meters now, students, then at 3 meters, if the this marker would be kept, then it would neither go here nor go there. That is, it is 1/3. 1/3. And in question, have they given the distance between the two bodies? So let me see. Yes, it is given. Students, r is given 9 meters. 9 meters. So now see, even did we didn't use the value 9 meters. Only then also we found how. How? By equating equations. So just put the value of r is equals to 9. Okay. X equals r by 3. X equals 9 by 3. X equals 3 meters. So 3 meters from the 2 kg. So now write the, in good handwriting, write the answer. The null point is at 3 meters from 2 kg body and dash meters from 8 kg body. Write it. Okay. Write the answer. Fill in the blanks for you. Comment section. Answer. Okay. Let's take one more question. Okay. Are you enjoying? Reply me. The force, a body falls through a height h at certain time on earth. If the same body falls on related planet having mass and radius twice that of earth, the distance through which it falls in same time is. You want to solve this? I think so, you can solve. Okay, we have to find, compare two bodies. If it takes height h on earth, then what will be the height on next planet if it is falling? You have to equate time, because they have given at the same time. Okay, in next planet, find the value of g and use kinematics in question number 20. Question number 20, MCQs. So these are equal, simple questions. Okay, all this you will solve on your own. Assertions and reason type questions, these are very interesting. This answer you will have to solve on your own. Now the next part, you have to keep asking questions. Okay, whenever there is any question, we will set up a Google link for you. We can interact with the doubts, but first solve it on your own. Okay, next part I could send you for homework this entire week. Okay, if any doubts you have, you can ask. Okay, and also solve this last crossword puzzle. Okay, students, thank you.